2 1 2 1 2 Assalamualaikum. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another episode of What's Going On Malaysia. My name is Harith Iskandar. First of all, thank you for joining me. Tonight's a bit special. Not only are we live on Facebook and YouTube, but we're also live on TikTok and Instagram and in the Joke Factory. We are live in the Joke Factory, Tuan-tuan dan puan-puan. At this very moment, saya sedang berada di club comedy nombor satu di Malaysia. Why are we number one? Because we're the only one. But, no, that's not true. But thank you for joining me. If you are watching this right now, if you're watching it live, please, I'm not talking to the TikTokers and the IGers. I know the language, yo. Your TikTokers and IGs. I'm talking to the FBers and the YouTubers. If you're watching this on Facebook or YouTube, share this episode right now. If you're watching on Facebook, if you're watching on YouTube, just copy paste and share it in your WhatsApp group and have more people watching. We will be following your comments right now. I can see Brian Kwan says hi. Hi, Harith and everyone. Noor Lily says hi. Maizatul Nadwa. Malavaran R. Murgaya. Catherine Raju. Thank you for watching. And let me know where you're watching from. I know we get a lot of people watching from Australia, from New Zealand. We've had people watching from Croatia, from Portugal as well. And TikTok as well. I'm going to be talking to my camera people in TikTok. TikTok and IG, you can move around. Eh? Don't need... Because these guys are standing there like this. Like that. Penat juga. Okay, so guys, tonight's episode is, I'm excited about this because usually we get all political and we start saying things and people get upset and angry and hurry, why you don't ask this question? Why you don't ask that question? Tonight we're in the celebratory mood. Celebratory. I thought I was going to screw up that word. I didn't. Celebratory. Itulah dia. To cara Melayu cakap, celebratory mood. It's still Chinese New Year. Chinese New Year. Jen, is it still Chinese New Year? How many days is Chinese New Year? 15 days, and we are on day 8 or 9. And yesterday was a big day because yesterday was a big day for the Hokkiens, right? The Hokkien go. I tell you, there's some Hokkien families around my house. Pukul satu pagi, but I'm cool with it because I was out there on the road as well. Like, yay! And then some people were shouting at me because, hey, we're trying to sleep. Don't sleep. Let your kids sleep in. Let them not go to school. My wife actually said, maybe the kids don't need to go to school tomorrow. I was like, no. If they want to punting, they need to try and cheat me and punting. I don't want my kids growing up knowing that their dad let them punting. Let them cheat me and punting. Let me find out that they're punting the way I did to my parents. Kanak-kanak kat rumah, jangan ikut apa yang... Abang Harith buat, okay? Anyway, guys, I'm talking too much. I've got some amazing guests coming on today, and I would like to introduce the first one to you. And for the first time ever on What's Going On Malaysia, we're going to be opening up with a song. And I heard her rehearsing the song early on in the sound check, and I just heard a couple of verses, but I'm way into it already. So, ladies and gentlemen, Chade, I feel like an RTM announcer. Dengan tidak membuang masa lagi, tuan-tuan dan puan-puan, apakah ada kita mewelcomekan into the studio? Mewelcomekan perkataan baru dalam Dewan Bahasa dan Pustaka. Kita mewelcomekan ke dalam studio. Tidak lain, tidak bukan, Jay. I don't know why they say that. Tidak lain, tidak bukan. I don't even know if they said that, but I said it. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Layla Sania. Please take it away.
Yes,
Up on stage, guys. That's awesome. That's Layla Sanders. She's my guest for tonight. Oh yeah. Oh, I like it. The walking music. That's cool. That's all good. Hey everyone, that was Layla Sanders. Already the comments are blowing up. Layla's gonna bring her mic up here because we are live in the Joke Factory and we are approximately 1 meter apart. We're going to be wearing our masks. So sebab kalau tak pakai nanti kena kecam kan dengan netizens. Layla, how are you? Assalamualaikum. Welcome to the show.
Waalaikumsalam. I'm doing very okay lah.
You're okay. Just now when you came, you said you were nervous.
I am.
But why?
Because it's my first time performing my new single with a keyboard. Usually I sing with my nurse one. So this is the first time. And I was shaking, if people can see.
Oh, wait a minute. So someone did ask just now. Someone was asking, anyone know this name of the song? Owen Cho was asking. That is Layla's own song. What is the title?
Yes. Bambino.
Bambino. And yes. Because I understand Chinese and Mandarin, I knew exactly what that song was about. But I will let you explain it. itu dia. Because I know already. So for those of us who don't speak Mandarin, what are the lyrics about?
So actually, it's about not judging a book by its cover. So the title is Bambino. Bambino is the cat with no fur.
The cat, you know, with no fur?
Yeah, you know the cat with no fur?
No, I don't know the cat with no fur.
It's like a sphinx lah, but...
Okay.
It's a type of sphinx, but it's called Bambino.
Uh-huh.
So you see, dia macam garang kan, Bambino tu. But actually, Bambino is very manja kind of cat.
Ah.
So this song is about not judging people by their appearances.
And... exactly. Would you be talking about yourself in that song? Are there some kind of imagery, symbolicness as well? How did you come up with that song, the lyrics?
So I didn't. It's not me. I would like to say that I did that beautiful song, but it wasn't me. So it was from Highway. Highway is a composer from Penang.
Yes. Yeah, because I know, because it takes a highway to get to Penang. Bada bang! The comedy has begun. Nama dia highway ke?
Nama dia highway.
Yes. Itu mesti bukan nama sebenar. I doubt his parents gave birth to him and like, anak kita, apa kita namakan dia? Highway, no.
So it's his nama sebenar.
Nama sebenar?
Yes, he's a Chinese guy, so it's highway, it's normal lah.
Oh, as in highway.
Yes.
Okay, I'm sorry. Sorry, segue. Kita segue on the highway. So Highway wrote this song, not judge a book by its cover. Ladies and gentlemen, before we go on, I just want to say that I have to admit, Layla, the first time I noticed you or you came to my attention was just over the Chinese New Year when someone, a very good friend of mine who was also interviewed you, yes. Dato Sri Wong Chen Wai, shared your video with me. And I said, my God, who is this? Who is this talent? And I had no idea. And I have to say, I had no idea. I posted it up. Can someone let me know who she is? Almost immediately, people were like, boom, boom, tagging you and all. And so I my team contacted you straight away. And you, because what was beautiful about it was not only did you have a great voice and you were singing the song, but my Chinese friends were telling me that your diction, your pronunciation, everything about it was impeccable. So how is it that you come to speak and sing in Mandarin?
So, since I was in Tarika, until SPM, I sekolah Cina je. So, Mandarin is like one of my first languages. If I go to bank, they ask me to give IC number, I have to say in Mandarin, then translate into Malay.
Really?
Yes. Yes.
You think in Mandarin and then translate to Malay.
So, it'll be like, 02110222, like that.
Okay, and is this the cause of you going to Mandarin school?
Yes, this gentleman over here.
Camera pan across. This is Layla's father. Boss, Tuan, what do I call you? Tune. Of course. Of course, his name is Tune. He plays the guitar. He's brought up a musical family. What other name would he have? If his surname was Les and he was Tuneless, I don't think so. Not happening. So, hold on. Do we have an extra mic? I just want to give to... I want to find out, why did you decide to send your children? I presume you sent all your children to Mandarin school? You're bad with languages, and so you've decided you don't want your children to be bad with languages. That is absolutely brilliant. I'm tabik spring to tune. Okay, so you went to Mandarin school from kindergarten sampai
SPM.
What? Well, I tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, I have said this in a tweet before, and I can jump for some reason. And all I said was, June, you were like this. I said, I wish I had learned Mandarin in school, waktu saya kat sekolah, which was not so long ago, 1970s. But I just tweeted that. I wish I had learned Mandarin in school. I wish I was taught Mandarin in school, and I can jump left, right, and center. But I am so glad that your father decided to do this for you. How do you feel about it? Was it awkward? Is it now? What are your thoughts on having been schooled in a Mandarin school, Mandarin speaking school?
At first, it was very difficult because only I can speak Mandarin. My mom cannot. My dad cannot. So all of the homeworks I have to do by myself. But over time, I pergi my neighbor's house, and then she's a Chinese girl, so she taught me lah. Skit, skit, skit.
But you're exactly right. So yeah, because you wouldn't be able to turn to your parents and daddy, and how do I spell this or what does this mean and all. But you worked it out. Now you've come to the point, you know, let's forget about your incredible skill of the Mandarin. We'll get to that in a moment. Your musicality, your singing, is this directly related to Encik Tune over there from a young age?
This is a funny story. Okay. I start singing before I talk. When I was 8 months old, I sang first before I talk.
Betul. You started singing before you were talking.
Yes.
How? Okay. I can't even imagine that.
Yeah, actually, I didn't believe him at first, but he has proof. They had a proof. So when he was making a song for a certain person, I just grabbed his mic and sang into the mic. So he recorded it. He said, if one day I hit stardom, he's going to release that song.
Okay. I'll be the first to download it, brother. So you started singing before you started speaking. So it's in you, lah. The music is in you.
I think so.
Yeah, and so did you just decide at one point very early on that that's what you want to do in life? Or is, I mean, I'm assuming that's what you're doing right now. You tak bekerja basuh kereta ke, tak ada?
Oh, actually, I have, I'm currently studying diploma in early childhood education because daripada kecil, I want to become a teacher. Yeah, so
okay,
a teacher and a singer. I want to do both. I don't want to leave any behind.
Okay.
So I'm just going to, yes.
You're doing a diploma in?
Early childhood education.
Early child, what? Apa dengan budak-budak nowadays? They want to become somebody. What? When I was your age, what do you want to become? No, I don't know. No idea. I couldn't even say diploma in early education. So but that is absolutely amazing. So you are actually, you are studying something and at the same time pursuing your musical career. And of course, you are hitting all the right notes with your mandarin. I'm not going to like lead the question in, but where do you see yourself? Are you going to consider yourself a singer of Mandarin songs or English? Because later on, you're going to be doing a couple more songs, Malay and English. Where do you see yourself going?
I think I want to try all. I don't want to limit myself. If I can try different languages, I will. Like maybe Tamil songs ke in the future. Maybe Spanish ke, French ke. So I'm just going to try. I don't want to limit.
Have you recorded already? Like, I know people don't do albums now and all. You're on Spotify, right?
Yes.
Let people know how to find you on Spotify.
So you can find me on Spotify with Layla Sania.
Layla Sania, L-A-Y-L-A Sania. And how many songs do you have up there?
I think I have, oh my God, I have five.
Five songs? Five songs. Is Bambino up there?
That yes, song? Bambino's
there. I'm going to go check that out in a moment. And also, before we bring in my next guest, also in a similar vein, the video which was shared to me over Chinese New Year, have you noticed a certain, is it because of that video now that people like me who were clueless before this are starting to get to know you more, or how's your rise of people recognizing you gone so far?
I think actually I did not expect it to go that viral because it's actually just a product Chinese New Year video. I just did a simple guitar playing and wish. So usually people don't like to watch videos like that. So suddenly everybody starts sharing. I'm terkejut. I tak sangka. So alhamdulillah lah, I decided to do that video. And now many people know me.
There you go. And we're going to be, Layla's going to stay in the studio with us right now. I want to bring somebody else. Also, I would consider a viral talent. Also came to my attention over Chinese New Year. I don't know what it is with this Chinese New Year. People are sending lots of WhatsApp clips to me. This young gentleman is not with us in the studio right now. He's actually in Penang. So we're going to be bringing him in right here on the screen. Ladies and gentlemen, let's bring Meer and Nash into the studio. Meer, apa khabar?
Hi, assalamualaikum everyone. I'm good. Oh my God, I'm so happy to be here. Thank you for having me. And it's nice to meet you. It's not actually meeting. It's meeting you guys. Haris and also Layla. Hi, Layla. Ni hao.
Okay, so these two are going to start talking Mandarin. They're going to leave me out of it. But no, it's okay. Meer, thank you so much for being on the show. So just so that people like me who are clueless before this will get to know you why did you hit the headlines? I know there was a competition, I believe, in China itself where you got second place or something. Is that right?
Yeah, I went to China for a competition. It's called the 16th Chinese Bridge Chinese Proficiency. And I'm actually wakil Malaysia masa pergi to that competition. And it has banyak contestant lah all around the world. Total macam like 114 countries. So ada 114 contestants from all around the world. So yeah, I managed to got number 2 and I'm happy. Yeah.
Okay, just so that people can visualize what you just said, I think we have a little clip from that competition. Oh. We're just going to play it right now.
我亲爱的外婆今天来到了现场。外婆,
it's my grandmother.
外公走了。今后就由我来守护您。让我来为你唱那首外公最爱的绿岛小夜曲。
So Meer, that is your grandmother. She went over for the competition with you.
Yes, my whole family went to the final. Yeah.
When was that?
Because they made a promise. It was 2017, and oh my God, I look so young.
Yeah, because now you look really old, Meer. Oh my God, you look like you're what, 12?
I'm 22 now. Like, you know, I'm 22.
Oh, 22.
I was 18.
So old. Oh my, oh, too new. 22. I remember when.
No, I lied. I'm 26.
Okay. So Meer, just racially, Bangsa, what's the background? Wait, what's your heritage?
Okay, so my mom is Chinese and my dad is Malay. So that make me half Chinese and half Malay. So, but I went to Chinese school since kindergarten. My parents sent me to Chinese kindergarten. So I learned Mandarin until I was form 3. And then I was like, Mom, I don't want to learn Mandarin anymore. It's very difficult for me. And I wanted to learn pendidikan Islam so bad. Because my Chinese school macam tak ramai orang Melayu, so that's why diorang tak banyak like pendidikan Islam punya class. So I took that as an excuse to not study Mandarin anymore.
Okay, Layla, did you have a similar experience? Like, were there any other Malay children in your school growing up?
So actually, it's quite different. My school, there's a lot of Malay. So we sampai kena separuhkan the class. So weird lah your school, kesian lah.
We have because I'm in Penang. I'm in Penang. So macam my school, the whole school, form 1 sampai form 5, ada tak sampai 10 orang pun orang Melayu. That's why.
Oh, but you know what? At the end of the day, I think I will just say on behalf of someone watching from the outside, the two of you, have such a valuable experience going to school, learning a third language, and being able to not just be proficient in speaking, but also singing as well. Meer, are you from a musical family? Do you have a tune in your family as well?
I don't have a tune in my family. I'm not like Layla. my father actually plays the guitar and he sings, but he never played in front of me. I've never seen him singing or playing the guitar. But the rest of my family just like nothing to do with the music, like nothing. So I don't know why I macam sesat dekat music. I think the music like chose me. So I started singing masa primary school. My teacher actually macam she went into the class and she's like, okay, this year, who's gonna join the singing competition? And macam biasa, all the students is gonna be like, pandang bawah, tak nak pandang the teacher's eyes, don't want to make any eye contact. So out of sudden, my teacher macam, okay, Meer, I think you. Like, I've never sang in my life. I went back home, I cried to my mom, I cried to my grandma. I was like, hell no, I'm doing this, you know? I don't know how to sing. I don't even know what is music at that time. But my family was very supportive and they were like, you know what, let's just go to kedai buku and buy the karaoke punya CD, you know. My zaman was that. So we actually
your
practiced
zaman.
At home.
Oh, wait a minute. Yeah. Wow. That, you mean that long ago? Hello, my zaman was cassette tape. Bang! No, you're even younger than me. Okay. So you literally had zero musicality in your family tree, but it came to you.
Yes, the music, I think the music chooses me. So yeah, I'm it's my passion till today. So I'll keep making music.
Okay, do you have anything on Spotify as well?
Oh, I have 10 singles, by the way.
10 singles. And how do people find you on Spotify?
People can find me on Spotify. Just type Meer Nash, MEERNASH. I have Chinese single. I have Malay single as well. Yeah.
Okay, guys. Okay, I'm going to be asking Layla first. Layla, when you the stuff that you're recording, what is it now? Do you record at home? What's the setup? How do you manage that?
So my dad has a more professional studio than mine.
Okay.
I just have like my laptop, my keyboard. So usually the mastering, I would go to his studio, but other things I would do by myself lah.
The mastering. I'm sitting here as if I know what she's talking about. Mengangguk kepala. Oh, the mastering. I would go to your dad's studio too for the mastering. Padahal entah apa masteringnya, aku tak tahu. So what about you, Meer? Where do you record your materials?
Okay, first of all, I just want to say, Layla, 我羡慕你，你很幸运，你有一个爸爸可以做音乐给你。Yeah, I don't have.
You know what, guys?
Help me with that.
Why don't the two of you talk about me in Mandarin, right? And all the Mandarin viewers, like, make them laugh and talk shit about me. I don't care. And I will just, guys, have a conversation about me in Mandarin.
Okay, so you know, 我刚刚要跟你讲，我一到的时候我很紧张，然后啊，他啊在那个camera后面啊，他真的很凶啊。
啊，他很凶的。刚才他跟我 video call 的时候啊，他很好的哦，我不知道他在 back behind the scene 这样凶的哦。没有，他不是很凶，很像很
angry 很坏的凶这样，他只是很像很 strict 啦，不像他现在。哦，对，他现在是假的啦。
You know what? I agree exactly. What did you all understand, right? That's right. No idea, right? You all cakap apa tadi?
I said you're so good looking.
Of course.
Yes.
I knew that. Why is Gian laughing behind the camera?
Yes, I said you're so good looking. Uh-huh. When you came in, your aura was like, oh my gosh.
Dah makan. Then bawa I into there. So, but thank you so much. There's people in the comment section that like they wish they could speak Mandarin as well. I just want to. Let's talk about where you are right now. You've both got singles on Spotify. You've got music on Spotify. Layla, what's your goal? What's your ambition? What's your dream? Where do you want to see us? Where do you want to go?
Actually, when I first started, my goal was to sing at Chinese speaking countries. Means go to Chinese speaking countries and just introduce myself. But now I think I've changed. I just don't want to limit myself. I just want to keep on trying anything lah. Yeah.
But you don't have that goal of going to Chinese speaking countries because the market there is huge.
Oh yeah. That's my first goal, to go to Chinese speaking countries.
Yeah. So from my time it was Sheila Amza, and I actually know her personally, and I know her journey over there. And at one point she literally stayed there for I think 6 or 8 years. And you know, although she had a small segment of the market, it still was like 50 million people. Yes. And that was like a small segment. Do you see yourself doing that?
Amin lah kalau dapat macam tu kan. Hmm. Alhamdulillah lah kalau tak dapat, maybe that's not my rezeki.
Okay.
But I'm going to keep on working hard so that I can go somewhere there.
Okay. And Meer, what about you? Where do you see yourself? What is your goal? What is your dream?
Okay, I've been to China. I tried my luck there, and the people there was like, this is just another Chinese. You don't look like the people from other country. You don't look like, you know, you know, like Malay. Then they don't even know what is Malay. So you have to explain it. So it's kind of hard for me to do that. But like Layla said, don't limit ourselves, and I'll keep trying lah. Like, you know, any chances I'll take it. And I host as well. I act as well. Even though I started with music, but I like to try other new stuff. Mana tahu boleh jadi?
You know what? I like what you just said, because at the end of the day, music is not just about music. It is also about image and how you look and how you stand out, especially in markets like China as well. But you're in a kind of like a dilemma as well, because over here you're like, hey, Melayu nyanyi lagu Cina. Over there you're like, you look Chinese. It works against you in that way. However, what I do admire and respect about the both of you is, like, you know what? Any setback or any batas kebatasan that's put ahead of you, you just go ahead and do what you need to do to get things done. Meer, I asked you just now. I know you're back in Penang. You don't have your instrument. Could you just give us a little bit of a melody or a song one of your own, perhaps, that you can just let the audience hear to get an idea about the kind of tonality you have?
Okay, so I covered this song last year. It's called Peluang Kedua, but it's in Mandarin. It's called 抱歉如果伤害了你. So it sounds like this. 抱歉如果伤害了你 原谅我不是故意不知不觉伤害了你会万分抱歉因为我也伤痕累累请求你让我再次的爱护你再次感受你的爱.
Yeah. Nice, very nice. Understood every single word of it. So you said you covered that song. Is that actually a Malay song, or
yes,
it's a Malay song, and someone's written the Mandarin lyrics to it?
I think he wrote that Mandarin lyrics himself.
Did you?
Yeah. I wrote the Mandarin lyrics with my cousin. Yeah.
Oh, nice. You know what?
Yeah, I like to do that.
Do you? I used to do that as well. I used to go to karaoke, sing an English song, but just change to Malay.
Engkau sekali,
dua kali, tiga kali perempuan. It's an old song. Q knows what I'm talking about. But hey, guys, dude, brainstorm. Like, what if the two of you at one point in the near future did a collabo? You know what I'm saying? That would be something.
I would love to, because I'm a fan of Bambino, by the way, Layla.
Oh, thank you. I'm a fan of Sarang He. So.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah, look at the love on stage right now. But seriously, I think that would be awesome, because end of the day, and let's face it, it's all about marketing. It's all about branding. I think the two of you not only have your own voice and have your own identity and have your own uniqueness, but put together, who knows, right? How does it work? Is it like Layla, is it like back in my day, you know, you had to be signed to a label kind of thing, but right now you're producing yourself, you're putting your own music out there. How does it work in terms of distribution, into like, for example, if you wanted to collab with someone like Meer, you know, do you have to sign anything? How does it work?
Well, I'm actually signed under Warner Music Malaysia right now. Okay. I'm an artist under Warner Music Malaysia. So I think everything has to go through Warner Music.
Okay.
But especially for Meer, if you want to collab with me, we'll do it belakang lah.
Okay. Why not? Umar Azman says, why not all three of you sing together? Because Umar, you don't want it to rain. Too much rain already since December. Penang lagi baru kena storm. The two of them singing, all good. My voice masuk, the storms that you saw hitting Penang, like the bridge would fall, man. So I can come in with the rap part. You know, I just put my microphone like that and just do a little bit of rapping. That's what the rappers do. But so seriously, hold on. Radma Murthy says, my daughter used to sing a Chinese song in Indian tune. You know what? I'm just a magical ideas. Layla and Meer come out with a Tamil song. What?
Wow. What? Hey, that's actually really nice. I've said it before that I'm going to learn Tamil after this. Because
do you know any? Because your dad?
Dia keturunan mama. But he cannot speak Tamil. So I'm going to learn and teach him. Yes.
You are
going
to
learn.
You know how to speak Tamil?
I don't know. But I'm going to. I hope.
Okay, I know 1 to 10.
Do you? Okay. Let's hear it.
Yeah. Onna, renda, moona, nala, anji, ala, yedu, yetu, umputa, pata, I messed it up, but something like that.
Sing it though. Yeah, just let it all go. Guys, this is absolutely insane. You know what I love about the two of you? I'm not gonna ask your age, Layla, because Meer has already declared it. I like the fact that both of you are you're at the stage in your life where you're ready to explore everything. And that is, let me tell you, that is the best way to look at it. And I'm not saying you need to just do that when you're young. You can do that when you're older as well. But you are ready to explore anything and ready to go anywhere. Let's talk about the last 2 years we've been in the the pandemic, we've been in lockdown. Now, you know, I come from an era when, you know, this last 2 years has been extremely trying because we've been out all the time. What has been your experience of the last 2 years?
Honestly, I think from social media-wise, there's not much difference because everything's done online, kan, bila pandemic ni. So we did live stream. So I think on that side, dia tak banyak sangat ganggu. But there's no live performances, kan. I cannot meet people. Cannot salam-salam, hi-hi. So that's just satu. That's the only.
You only said back, you couldn't travel and talk to people and meet people. What about you, Meer? What's been happening with you in the last 2 years?
I missed out a lot of chances to join competitions in China because of pandemic. And sekarang ni, bila umur dah melepasi the requirement for that competition, I can't turn back time anymore. So it's a loss for me lah.
But with every loss, a new door opens, there is a new gain. Macam Tony Robbins pula aku. Didn't know I had it in me. All right, Meer, I just want to say thank you so much for taking the time, for being with us, for sharing your talent with us. I'm actually truly looking forward to hearing more stuff from you. Before I let you go from the studio, because we're going to let Layla do another couple of songs, is there anything else that, you know, I've not brought up or you'd like to talk about it? Anything you want to say out there to all the people watching?
Okay, so first of all, thank you to Joke Factory and Abang Haris Iskandar. It's a pleasure to meet you here. And I just want to say to all my fans who are watching right now, thank you so much for supporting me, even masa I lows or masa I tengah naik or whatever, even until now. And don't forget to stream my latest single, Sarang Hei. It's a K-pop and pop song yang Layla sebut tadi. So yeah, I hope you guys can follow me on Instagram and follow my journey kalau I ada keluar lagu baru in the future. And I can't wait to see you guys. And please stay safe. Sekarang ni kes banyak naik. Yeah.
Okay, thank you so much, Meer. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you for being part of the show. And we will definitely catch up with you when you come back to KL. All right, take care.
Yes. Take care. Bye,
thank
guys.
You. Okay, so that's Meer Nash. He's on IG and Spotify as well. As promised, Layla has promised a couple more songs for us. Layla, maybe you can go and set up at the keyboard. Let me know when you're ready. If you are on Spotify or if you're on IG, please go check out Meer Nash as well as Layla Sania. And if you're on TikTok as well, you know, don't forget. Are you on TikTok as well, Layla?
Yes, I am. Yeah, of course. TikTok.
Same Layla Sania?
Yes, everything Layla Sania.
Everything is Layla Sania. All right. So you've got another song for us right now. What is this? What have you got for us this time?
I actually have two songs. One, because I sang one song in Mandarin earlier. So I'm going to sing one song in English and one song in Malay.
Cool. Layla, take it away.
Yes. This next song, I'm going to be singing a song called Aku Dia Dan Lagu. When I was younger, I liked to listen to old songs. People call me the girl with an old soul. So this is one of the songs, one of my favorites. Serata alam kini katanya cinta. Kau memberi senyuman rindu, ku tak dapat melupakanmu. Kau kuiring senyuman mesra walau semalam saja. Suasana sunyi itu kisah semalam. menjadi suatu ciptaan. Kisahku dia dan lagu jangan dipisahkan. It's one of my favorite songs. But before I sing my final songs, thank you so much for inviting me today. It's been really fun. And I hope you guys can follow me on social media. Do take care of yourselves. And also, I have a movie that's in cinemas right now. It's called Small Town Heroes. Make sure you guys go watch it. Okay. With his same old secret, me and my head high and my tears dry, get on without my guide. You went back to what you know, so far from all that we went through. And life's like a pie, and I'm a tiny penny rolling up the walls inside. We only say goodbye with words. I died 100 times. You go back to her and I'll go back to her. I'll go back to us. And I love you much. It's not enough. You love Flo and I love her. And life is like goodbye, and I'm a tiny penny rolling up the walls inside. Whoa, we only said goodbye with words. I died 100 times. You go back to her, and I'll go back to you. We only said goodbye with words. I died 100 times. You go back to her and I'll go back to Thank you.
Awesome. That's Amy Winehouse.
Yes.
I think she died before you were born.
Yes.
No, not quite. You a fan of Amy Winehouse?
Yes, I'm a huge fan of Amy Winehouse.
Oh, God. I'm going to have a little Amy Winehouse moment gone too soon. She was absolutely amazing. She brought back the blues. She brought back the soul. And I got to say, when I was listening to you sing that, you did really, really well.
Thank you.
You yang ajar kan, the soul ni, the blues, the feel. Oh, atuk dia yang Winehouse. Oh my God, we're talking musical right now. So guys, thank you so much. If you've been watching, everybody on TikTok as well and on Instagram, thank you for watching. Thank you for being a part of this. Layla as well as Meer are on here on Spotify. Where else can they find you?
You can find me on YouTube, on Spotify, on Instagram, on Twitter, on TikTok, everywhere.
Everywhere, just like and probably at the stalls in Jalan Ampang somewhere.
Mungkin.
One day.
Jual nasi lemak ke?
Mana tahu, you know, having some psychological sessions with kids in the future. But follow. Like, subscribe. Also to Harith Iskander, if you're watching, if you're catching us for the first time, I want to say thank you so much, Layla, for
thank
being
you
part
so
of the
much.
Show.
Thank you, so
thank you for sharing your talent with us. And I believe you have some younger siblings as well who are.
Oh yeah.
I saw on your Instagram there was you were doing some a cappella kind of like harmonies and all.
Yeah.
Ridiculous. Ridiculous talent. Guys, thank you for watching. Thank you for being part of the show. I do What's Going On Malaysia basically because I want to know what's going on with my beautiful country. And I'm so glad for Meer as well to find and discover new talent, especially over Chinese New Year, talent such as the two of them. And I hope you guys have discovered someone new as well. And if you have new talent that you think I've not heard about, please let me know in the comment section as well. And I'll see you guys real soon. Thank you so much, Layla. Is there anything you want to say before we head off into the blues?
Baby, just stay safe, be happy, be yourself. Don't limit yourself. Do whatever you love.
Itulah dia. Ni bapa dia entah apa aja. If it's my dad, he'd be like, go to school, stay to school. Don't sing. Shut up. Penyanyi. Kau nak jadi penyanyi, aku diam sekali. Pow! Kena one time. But that was back in the day. Thanks, guys. I'll see you guys real soon. Take care. Good night, everyone. You have another song? Any song you want to just play? Just like jam? Just to... Ada apa-apa? Anything?
Should I just sing the song I sang? Oh,
can. Yeah. Special for you guys. Special for you guys.
Okay.
Come. Tak apa.
Yes, saya pun lama dah tak nyanyi.
What song is it?
It's 我的心里只有你没有他.
I knew that
yes,
one.
Yes, right.
the water sing song. No, no. Okay, go.
What the singly只有你没有他，你要相信我的情意并不假，只有你才是我梦想，只有你才叫我牵挂，我的心里没有他。 我的心里只有你没有他，你要相信我的情意并不假，只有你才是我梦想，只有你才叫我牵挂，我的心里没有他。我的心里只有你没有他，你要相信我的情意并不假，我的眼睛为了你看，我的眉毛为了你画，从来不是为了他。 Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone. I'm just live here on TikTok. Thank you for watching. Stay safe, everyone, and we'll see you real soon on What's Going On Malaysia. Take care. Good night. Assalamualaikum. Bye, everyone. Bye.